Yeah, hi guys. So I'm Claire, and like Emma said, I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about daily school life in Spain. So I studied abroad in Sevilla, Spain, which is in the southern part of Spain, for about 5 months this past spring. So while I was there, I was taking classes at the university in Sevilla. So I got to have sort of a firsthand look at what college was like there. And also while I was there, I lived with a host family. And so I had three host siblings, and one was 9, one was 14, so probably around the same age as a lot of you guys, and one was 17. So through them, I got to see, like, learn a little bit about what their school was like, elementary school, middle school, and high school. And also while I was there, I got the opportunity to volunteer with a kindergarten class in their English class. And so I got to sort of see a little bit of what a kindergarten class is like in Spain. So I'm going to sort of talk to you a little bit about each of the different levels. I'll start with, you know, elementary school and then work up to college. So one of the biggest differences that I noticed between sort of elementary school or sort of K-12 school in general between Spain and the U.S. Is that in Spain, a large majority of the schools are Catholic schools. So Spain is a predominantly Catholic country. Almost everyone who lives there identifies as Catholic, and it's also a really big part of the culture there. So it's really super common for kids to go to Catholic schools instead of just regular public schools. So for example, my host siblings went to a Catholic school, and the school I tutored at was a Catholic school. So you guys are in a public school. I went to a public school when I was, in elementary school, middle school, high school. And so it's a little bit different. You know, they have to wear uniforms. They have, you know, church services as part of their school a few times a week and things like that. So that was one big difference I noticed, was that that was a lot more common there. Another big difference was that students don't usually eat lunch at school. So in the U.S., most people are in school, you know, from 7 or 8 in the morning till like 3 in the afternoon or something. And so, you know, you have a little lunch break, you eat lunch at school. But my host siblings were in school. They started school around maybe 7 the same time, but they ended around 2:30, and they would come home and eat lunch with their families. And part of that is because in Spain, lunch is the most important meal of the day. So it's sort of traditional that everyone eats lunch with their families. It's a really big meal. So instead of, you know, eating lunch at school around noon, they'd wait, come home at 2:30. We'd all eat lunch together. So that was one big difference. And then as far as, you know, what they're learning in school, most of it is really similar stuff, you know, math, history, science, things like that. One thing I noticed that was really different is that there's a lot more of an emphasis on learning foreign languages. So a lot of you guys said you had learned foreign languages in school. You know, when I was in elementary school, middle school, high school, I learned Spanish. But, you know, when I was in elementary school, Spanish is pretty basic stuff, colors, numbers, things like that. And I noticed that it was a lot more sort of intense the way they learned languages. So, for example, my youngest host sister was 9, and sometimes she would ask me to help her with her English homework, because they start taking English classes, you know, right away in kindergarten. And sometimes I'd look at the homework she was doing for English class, and I would be like, wow, this is kind of difficult, you know? It was, you know, having her write kind of complicated sentences and things like that, and she's only in, you know, 3rd grade. And the kindergarten class that I worked in was, the class I helped out in was an English class. And so it was a lot, they were doing stuff that was a lot more complicated, I thought, than just colors, numbers, things like that. You know, they were doing a lot more speaking. The teacher would have them say sentences in English and things like that. So I was always really impressed by, you know, what these 5-year-olds were able to say in a foreign language. And I know that most, 5-year-olds who are learning Spanish in their kindergarten class here in the U.S. maybe can't speak quite that well. So, and then on top of almost every student learning English starting when they're in kindergarten, most students start to learn another language when they get to middle school. So my host sister, who was 14, was taking English and German. So her English was already pretty good. And then, so starting around probably like sixth or seventh grade, she was also taking German classes. And she, my host sister who's 14, even studied abroad in Ireland when she was in middle school. So here that's, you know, really not as common. Most students, if they're going to study abroad, it's in high school or college, but there it's a lot more common for people to do it younger. And then my 17-year-old host brother had taken English, German, and French classes. So, you know, by the time students are graduating from college, they have the basics in up to four languages, which was really crazy to me because, you know, I feel like in the U.S., a lot of people learn a second language, but it's pretty rare to meet someone who speaks three or four languages. So that was one thing I noticed that was really interesting. And I think a big part of this is because where Spain is located in Europe, it's surrounded by lots of other countries that speak a lot of different languages. It shares a border with Portugal and France that both have their own languages. And it's really close to Italy where they speak a different language. And England, and you pretty much can't go anywhere without encountering people who speak different languages than you. And a lot of, you know, students in Spain, once they graduate, move to other countries in Europe to work. So it's super useful to have those skills and be able to sort of move wherever you are and be able to speak the language there. And on top of that, English especially is, you know, really common most places you go in Europe. It's pretty much, I noticed almost everyone there speaks some English on top of their native language, which is nice as an American traveling around because you can always find people who speak your language. But it's crazy to think that, you know, everyone is sort of expected to learn English as a second language just because it's so common. That being said, elementary, middle, high school in the US and Spain are still really similar in most ways. You know, they take the same basic types of classes we do. It's, you know, sort of similar how it's set up and the grades and everything. My host brother and sister played sports at their school and things like that. So I would say in general, the biggest differences I noticed between school in the U.S. and Spain was on the college level. And that's also where, you know, I had the most experience. So the biggest difference basically on the surface between college in the U.S. and Spain is that in Spain, pretty much everyone just goes to college in their hometown. In the U.S., usually students will apply to like anywhere from 3 to 10 different colleges, hear back, see which ones they get into, decide which one they think is best or where they want to live, and then maybe go to college in a different city or a different state. And that's really just not as common there. Most people will just, you know, apply to the one university in their hometown. That's where they want to go. And then they'll typically live at home, while they're going to college. And part of this, is a cultural thing in the idea that people really want to, you know, family is really important. People stay living with their family as long as possible. And another part of it is there's not as much of a difference in quality of schools in Spain. So, you know, a university in Madrid might not necessarily be that much better than a university in Sevilla. So there's no point in, you know, trying to go to a different one that's more competitive if they're all pretty equivalent. So another thing about college in Spain versus the U.S. is it's much, much cheaper there. And that's true of most places compared to the U.S., but it's really not crazy expensive in Spain. And sometimes people in Spain would ask me how much college costs in the U.S. And when I would tell them, they would just think it was crazy how much it costs here. So because of that, a lot of times people take more than 4 years to graduate from college. So here, the typical amount of time you're in college is 4 years, you graduate, you move on. And part of that is because it's so expensive, you don't want to spend another year paying for it. But in Spain, it's not uncommon for people to sort of take 5 or 6 years to go through that. But it's not as big of a deal if they're, you know, living at home and it's not costing them as much each year. And another big difference about college in Spain versus the U.S. is there you're expected to go into college completely knowing what you want to study. So that's great that a lot of you guys said you already had ideas of what you might want to study in the future. Personally, when I got to college, I did not know what I wanted to study at all. And it took me a year or so of, you know, taking different classes here at UNC to decide on what I wanted to do for my major. But it's a little bit different there. Instead of just applying to a school, you apply directly to whatever program you want to be in. And then you starting off, you're taking classes for that subject. You don't really take any other classes. So like if you were a biology major, you would have no reason to really take a history class or anything like that, which is a little different from here in the U.S. where as college students, we're expected to take a certain number of classes outside of our major as part of, you know, getting our college degree. It's also not as common for people to have to go to graduate school there. And part of the reason for that is, for example, if you decide that you want to be a doctor, in the U.S., you would, you know, go to 4 years of college, you maybe major in biology or something like that. And then after that, you would apply to med school and you would go to med school for however many years. But in Spain, and I know a lot of other places in Europe, what you do is you go in and starting year of college, you're studying medicine. And it might take a little bit longer than some of the other degrees. You might be in school for 5 or 6 years total instead of just that 4. But then you graduate and you have your medical degree. So you don't have to do your, you know, undergraduate degree and then also go to medical school, which is a little bit different. So in general, their classes in the at college in the US and Spain are still pretty similar. But just kind of the structure of how people, of what classes people are taking and when they're taking them is a little bit different. So that's kind of a summary of some differences I noticed between Spain and the U.S. while I was there. So now Emma is going to tell us a little bit about Italy.